Yan, syempre mga kabrigada, makakasama natin ngayon, of course, ang pride ng Jensen. Pag-usapan din natin mga kabrigada yung tourism naman dito sa General Santos and the whole South Sargent mga kabrigada. Kasama natin si Ma'am Maria Cora Tito ng City Tourism Office. Ma'am Maria Tito. Yeah, good morning, good morning.
Good morning everyone. Magandang Jensen and thank you so much for inviting me here.
Lela, go, go!
Si Ma'am Maria Cora Tito. Yan, nahihirapan po kasi parang pare-parehong pangalan yung kanyang pangalan. Oo. Ma'am Cora, ayan, kasama natin sa SEMCDU before, one of the heads in our office before. So, eto na po. How is tourism in our region ngayon? Ano ang mga pwede nating i-look forward to sa paparating na months?
Okay. Tourism ngayon sa region, especially in Jensen, because tayo yung lead city within the region. Mm-hmm. Because as what we have really observed, we are the commercial, industrial, and service center of tourism in Region 12. So General Santos City having the most number of accredited tourism establishments, make it hotel, restaurants, travel agencies, and transport system, tayo po ang pinaka-prime nga city in the region. Mm-hmm. So with that, there is an initiative of the region to be in Manila on April 11 to 14 to sell the region in parang siyang exhibit. It's really products, goods, and services in Manila, particularly in Glorieta Activity Center, Glorieta 3. So we will be going there. We will sell the region. We have a target of selling the whole destinations, packages, and services. And Jensen will be sending a delegation to that event on April 11 to 14. In fact, we'll be bringing along our tuna, the whole tuna, and it will be sliced there and to be given for free for all those who will visit the exhibit. It's called the SOX Travel and Trade Fair 2016.
Okay. Aside from the whole tuna that you're bringing, what would be the top products or destination, tourism destination of this region that you will be selling?
Actually, it is a regional initiative. This activity is, ang dami pong line agencies na kasama, like DA, Department of Agriculture, DENR, DWH, we have, we also have some other, I think it was TESDA for the ano, and especially DTI. DTI po ang in charge na magdadala ng lahat ng mga products of the region, especially yung mga selling products natin, top selling products. They were already identified. So in the whole of Glorieta, one section will be for products, another area will be for destinations, of which andoon yung the 9 LGUs that will participate, the 4 provinces and the 5 cities of the region.
Ang city tourism ba natin, Ma'am Cora, may target ng number of tourists na supposedly for this year na target natin makapasok, influx dito sa Jensen?
Yes, of course. We are targeting really at least 10% increase per year. 10 lang yung aming inaano. But actually, as of last year, 2015, we have 1.2 million tourists coming to Jensen. In fact, we are the number one area of the whole region as the highest number of tourist arrivals. Be it day tourist and tourist arrivals really. Because there are two types of tourists kasi according to DOT. Those tourists that will stay overnight, they're called really the tourists. And those who will just come and tour around and then go back to their home place to sleep, that is what we call day tourists. So both day tourists and tourists per se, we are the highest in the region as of 2015.
Yeah. Ma'am Cora, I think this is a legit issue ng mga turista. Ang Jensen, kilala as tuna capital. Pero pag pumunta ka ng Jensen, mapili mo lang mga lugar na nagbebenta ng tuna. Kung meron man, mahal. I don't know kung paano nire-resolve ng city ninyo, ng office ninyo, at ng DOT halimbawa, yung ganung mga issue.
Okay, most of the hotels and restaurants offers tuna. Ang among giano ngayon is make sure na even those small karinderia should also offer one. Say for example, kung natin mga lakbay aral diri, we usually point Chongson Arcade. Of which, malipay kayo sila maka-adto dito because they really, the food taste bahay, lutong bahay, yung mga ganun. So, they really look at. And we are also looking into it na as much as possible, maybe it even came into our mind na being the tuna capital of the Philippines, siguro magpaano tayo ng resolution, ipa-sponsor natin sa ating councilor, Ma'am Shandy, na to at least offer 3 to 5 tuna cuisines lahat ng establishments in the city.
Yan. Tama yan.
Kasi mahiya ka magkano nga, ah, tuna capital, wala ito na sa ano.
Oo, mahirapan
mo. But some of the hoteliers and the restaurateurs also, Association of the City is amenable to that. In fact, it came out during one of their meetings.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun na rin yung ano namin na dapat they should offer at least 3 to 5 tuna menus in all of their, in all restaurants in the city para naman being the tuna capital, they would also live up to the name.
Yeah, precisely, diba? Precisely. Okay. And also yung cost, di ba? Per kilogram ang panga ngayon, so maabot ng isang kain mo lang ng panga, yung umaabot ka lang ng, umaabot ka na ng 1,500, eh di sa ibang lugar ka na bumili, ganun din naman.
I don't think so, 1,500 ang isang panga, hindi naman siguro. I don't think so. In fact, if you buy tuna here or eat tuna here, tuna tastes best in the place where it calls home. Because andito yan siya. And also, it is the cheapest in Jensen, and I cannot argue with you when you say it's one, but I don't think so. Come on.
Wow, okay, let's move on to another topic, diba? Kasi syempre, what are the employment opportunities ngayon and na pwedeng pasukan din na pwedeng maliliit na business considering na Jensen is gathering around more than millions of tourists for the whole year.
Actually, the frontline tourism services is in the offing, no? Ang dami talagang kakailangan yan. Sa example, we lack tour guides. And then yung mga frontline service natin in our hotels that needs trainings also. So, we are now on the
verge. Sama mo na yung brownout.
Wala naman siguro, sir. Meron pa ba? I think the Sarangani Electric Edge Corporation is supplying the much needed lack of power supply in the city. So, we're just happy na ganun lang siya. Although, there are also issues regarding it, but we are still on the developing stage and we need power in order to power our businesses here also. So, with that, usually in the frontline tourism services, yun yung mga marami talaga, especially in the food sector, mga food and beverage service staff, and all those things na kakailanganin natin. In fact, pinakamaraming last year was the investment in the tourism field because ang daming nag-open ng mga hotels, extension of their rooms, mga ganun. So, dami ding staff, especially on the housekeeping front service, yung mga housekeeping staff, mga bellboys, and all those staff na kakailanganin in the tourism industry.
So, additional pa yun na employment opportunities for the generals and those coming here
of
in this
course.
Place.
Of course, and we in the tourism offices to eat that all the staff that can be deployed in these different various sectors in the tourism field must be capable enough. That's why we also conduct trainings together with DOT 12 in order to equip also our staff regardless their skills.
So, aside from the employment opportunities, ma'am ko, eto namang pag-usapan natin yung mga pwede pang magpapatayo or i-invest ng mga business related to tourism. Meron pang need for more hotels, right?
Of course, we still lack hotels. In fact, isang puntahan lang tayo ng isang convention, national convention,
puno na.
Kagaya ng tuna convention,
yes,
tuna
really
congress.
Full because aside from the fact that there is a convention, no? If there is a scheduled convention now, our hotels has already regular clients that comes here. We don't discredit the fact that we are a business city and businessmen come here, whether what kind of business that they have. So that's regular clients na nila yon. Dagdagan mo pa ng mga conventions or in fact 2 or 3 conventions sometimes magsabay. We really lack more rooms.
Talagang punuan siya. So pwede pang magpatayo ngayon ng mga pension houses, lodging house, or motels for that matter.
Mga backpackers, hotels, mga ganun na type. And then especially mga homestays. We also need that.
Yeah,
especially in our ecotourism sites where mas malayo siya
Can
sa city.
Can you please mention the ecotourism sites that we want to highlight?
Yeah, our ecotourism sites, especially the 4, we call the area as the Klaha Karst area. The Klaha because Klaha Karst, Karst, by the way, is a scientific name for the type of soil in the area, which is rocky.
Yes.
Mga ganun. So, it's Klaha. Klaha, simply because the main river that passes to the 4 barangays, which is Mabuhay, Connell, Upper Labay, and Olimpog. The same river that comes, that traverses among the 4 barangays. So, we call that area, alam ka naman, Olimpog, something like that, no? So, we call the area, our ecotourism potential talaga is this Laha Cars area. So in fact, come June or the later after election, tapos na po yung road in that area which it was funded by Chesa. So we are going to turn it over to the city na from Chesa. So we will be conducting another, but it will be after election na because so busy po ngayon ang ating
exactly. Okay, speaking about after election, ito yung isa sa mga pinaka-inaabangan ng mga taga General Santos, sa mga businessmen, yung years na to in the making, the one-stop business shop. O ano na po ang development nito? Ano bang pwede nating, baka naman pwedeng mga next month or 2 months after, baka naman 1 year or 2 years, pa kailan ba ito mabubuo, matatapos?
Actually, the building at the back of the City Hall, have you noticed it? It's called the Green Building. The building at the back of the City Hall is actually the business building of the city. It is a four-story building, of which the first floor will be designated as the one-stop shop year-round.
One-stop shop for the business permit.
For business permit procurement of some of the businesses here.
Processing.
So any time of the year, you just go there at the at that building, that green building, on the first floor. Lahat po, it's year-round. It's hindi tulad noon nga tag-January lang, di ba? So ngayon, it's year-round na
mas
po.
Mas madali, mas
mabilis. The building is already nearing its completion and our office also will be situated in that building.
Yay.
The whole of the third floor will be the SimCedu building.
Finally.
Of which the enterprise division, the investment generation division, and the tourism division will be placed on the third floor.
Ayun, finally. Talagang mas mapapadali ang buhay ng mga businessmen, ng mga investors, ng mga bago dito sa city na interested to put up their business. May dadagdag po po kayo?
Yes, actually, activities for the city.
Yun.
Okay? Incoming really is the General Santos Summer Youth Festival.
Ayan.
This GSYF actually is intended for the youth. Lahat sila, they will be encamped, may encampment po mangyayari sa Oval Plaza. And all of the youth, particularly from the various barangays, talagang may representation from the barangays because this activity is for them. It has 4 components. One is sports. So the sports is, lahat ng sports po, they will be trained. May mga sports clinic, basketball, all types of the sports. We also have the cultural side. We will be inviting musicians, no? Like say for example, mga songwriters and train our youth how to do it. Violinist, mga pianist from Manila in order to train our youth during summer instead of going outside, and might as well train this youth to become our future musicians and future leaders someday. We also have the Popcom division will also have their own trainings like the U4U. This is actually training the youth to become responsible adults. Like, yung mga issues like teenage pregnancies. Mm-hmm. Yun yung ipang-train na naman. And then on the other side, again, on every night, there will be a show at the Oval Plaza featuring all youth na sila. So, lahat na mag-manage sa Oval Plaza at flea market, it's managed by the youth themselves.
Wow.
So, particularly, this is own. So the city government's role is only to guide them, finance what are their activities, and it is in this summer. I think the opening will be on April 18.
Alright! Ayan, marami po tayong pwedeng pagkaabalahan, hindi lang ngayong summer. It's summer for the kids, for the youth. And syempre pa, all along the year, employment opportunities coming into us because of our tourism na talagang walang, there's no way but up for the tourism sector, tourism industry. Kaya thank you very much, Ma'am Maria Cora. Tito, may isa ka pa sasabihin, go.
Yeah, we are still one incoming event. That is the Jensen Eco Carrera Series,
okay,
of which we term it this year as the Jensen Tri 51.5.
Magaling. Kailan po yun?
That will be on June, the last week of June, June 25, because we cannot honor this on summer. It should have been summer, but because of the electoral exercise, we have to move it to June, and we are inviting all runners, enthusiasts in this type of race. It will be a new one. It's just, I know this year, but it's a part of the Jensen Eco Carrera Series, of which 51.5 kilometers of running, biking and swimming.
Triathlon.
So it's a triathlon type of event, and that will be on June 25, 26. And we are inviting everybody to please join as much as possible. We want it to become national in nature. Mm. We want to yeah. invite national runners and triathloners to come to Jensen and experience what we are preparing for this type of event.
Alright, yeah. Thank you very much once again, Ma'am Maria Coratito of the City Economic Management and Cooperative Development Office of General Santos City. Good luck po sa ating mga endeavors, sa ating mga targets for the tourism industry of this region, Region 12. Ayan nga, tuloy-tuloy na lang po tayo, Brigada Jun. And Ma'am Cora, we will have once again with us our singers, Jessa and Jolian, or Juliana, kasama si... Si Jolian, Jolian manggid no? Jolian and Renz kasama si Jessa, ayan.
Loving can hurt sometimes, but it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hurt sometimes, but it's the only thing make us feel alive. Ooh, we give this loving as photograph. Made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closer, hearts are never broken, ties forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till I'm me. You will never be alone. Wait for me to come home. Loving can heal. Loving can mend your soul, and it's the only thing that I know. I swear it could get easier. Remember only every piece of you. Ooh, and it's the only thing with us when we die. We give this loving as photograph. We make these memories for ourselves. Where our eyes are never closer, hearts are never broken, sighs forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You will ever be alone. And if you hurt me, and that's okay, baby, only words bleed. Inside these pages, you just hold me. I will never let you go. Wait for me to come home. 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 Oh, you can fit me inside the necklace you got when you were 16. Next to your heartbeat when it should be. Keep within your soul. And if you hurt me, well, that's okay, baby, only words bleed. Inside these pages, you just hold me. I will never let you go. When find a way, I will remember how you kissed me under the lamppost back on 6th Street, hearing the whisper through your phone. Wait for me to come home.
Yeah! Ayan, maraming salamat, Juliana and Renz! Ayan, syempre maraming salamat sa pag-gising ng maaga para naman makapagbigay ng aliw sa ating mga kabrigada. Baka gusto nyo i-greet yung mga auntie nyo, tita nyo, mami nyo sa mga bahay nila. Go!
Binabati ko po yung Daliba family, Asumbra,
At saka yung kuya ko, Kuya Jimboy, Ate Clarice, sila Kuya Gino, sila nanay, si tatay, sila Pastor Jonathan Olanday, saka yung mga youth.
Oo.
Yun lang. Ayan, maraming salamat, Julari. How about you, Ren?
Great ko lang yung barkada ko dyan at pamilya ko. Yun lang.
Ayan, oh, alam mo kay si Renz. Ayan, the end this summer, nag-offer ba kayo? Baka gusto ng mga mommies natin na turuan nyo silang kumanta o kaya turuan nyo silang mag-gitara. Open ba kayo for that? Open, open po. Ayan, saan ba kayo pwedeng makontakt? May Facebook ba kayo? Number natin, pwede natin i-plug.
Kung gusto nyo po ng mag-getter lesson, i-contact nyo lang po kami dito sa baba.
Sa baba, mga screen number.
Sa screen.
Screen number. Ayan. Maraming salamat once again, Juliana and Renz. Ayan. Pati V, kunin nyo na to sa Harana. Alam na. Oh, meron na ang susunod. Abangan. Alright. Syempre, mga kabrigada, thank you so much sa pagtutok. Dito pa rin sa Extra Extra Morning Hato. Kasama ang nakijamming sa atin si Juliana and Renz. See you next week. Hindi atin alam. Basta Harana na yan, Peg. Maraming salamat din po, mga kabrigada, sa ating sponsors na nasa likod. And of course, maraming salamat sa pagtutok. Hello muna sa mga taga-Bula, kung saan si Renz sa Purok 4A. And of course, sa lahat po ng taga-Pulamulok sa Cotabato, syempre John Mark Gula, Irish Grace Kapundag, and Rayo May Dolera. See you again next time, mga kahataw. Bukas, meron pa rin pong Morning Hataw. Tutok lang dito kasi Brigada News TV. Ako pa rin po yung kabrigada, Jessa Leduna. Back muna sa studio.
Yan, Brigada Jess Aliduna, kasama of course ang ano ba yun? Ang amin, di ba?
Oo, soon to be. Or tago-tago lang be. Yan.
By the way, mga kabrigada, sa April, bukas pala, April 9, mga kabrigada, ang grand finals ng First Brigada Video Game Challenge. At mga kabrigada, supportahan ninyo yan, mga kabrigada. At of course, April 16, ang operation tuli ng Brigada Group of Companies. Libreng tulit, libreng gupit, libreng pagkain, libreng video. Okay, yan mga kabrigada sa April 16.
Ayan, alright. Siyempre, don't forget, sama-sama ho tayo ngayong Sunday dyan sa Lagao Gym. Pwede po tayong magkita-kita dyan for April 10 in support of our champion. Siyempre, magkita-kita lang. But anyway, tomorrow, the video kit challenge. Alright, and eto lang. I just like to say hello and good morning kay Kuya Boyet B.I. din ha. Ang alami kayo magluto og squid. Thank you very much sa dinner the other night. Thank you. And of course, kay Irvin sa pag-slice og manga and all that. Turny V, good morning to you. Ryan and Shin and Marie and everyone else, nga Nadia sa Vilo, good morning sa inyo ha. Hope to see you soon. And ang gusto po din ako i-greet sa ito, Dapita. Percy, girl la, good morning to you and to your husband, Wilson, and to your baby boy, no longer baby, Miko, ako yung naanak, good morning sa inyo ha. Ali, Adi, Azzy, Abby, who are nasa bahay lahat. Magandang umaga sa inyo lahat. Mahal na mahal ko kayo, mega non. This is Kabrigadang Leila. See you tomorrow. Oy, tomorrow Saturday, we're still here.
Mga kabrigada, ang World Vision Society Church of God Incorporated, meron silang Blood Drive Movement April 17 sa isang mall dito sa Jensen. Pwede kayong makipag-ugnayan 554-2932. At sa wala pang copy ngayon, mga kabrigada, ng newspaper, pwede na mabili mga kabrigada copy ng Brigada Newspaper sa mga sukin yung mga newsstands, news magazines, at siyempre sa mga sukin news boys and news girls. Maraming salamat din sa Brigada Healthland Corporation sa maasahan, aprobado at epektibo ng mga food supplement. Power Cell Shabbat Capsule, Power Cell Soya Coffee, Curamed, Drive Max, NutriCleanse at Calcium Ascorbate Guard C. Hanggang sa susunod na episode ng Brigada ng Morning Hataw dito sa Brigada News TV, Services Our Passion. Ako si Brigada June Mendoza at ito ang
Morning Hataw!
Morning Hataw would like to thank Hair and Body Spa Avenue by Charmaine Inerio, located at San Pedro Street, corner Caparera Street, Barangay Lagao. Cadmax Custom-Made Art Crafts, located at Cabrera Swanville, Barangay Sinawal, Jansan. Cadmax.